Hello friends, in this video we will discussing about certain factors that influence human development. The factors which are culture specific factors that have significant influence of human development is a part of discussion of this video. Every culture has its own rules and regulations which directly or indirectly influences the individuals who are part of that culture. And we have to sort out that what are the cultural factors and associated components or aspects that have certain impact on the human development. You know, human development is a lifelong phenomena. From the date of conception, from the moment of conception to the end point where human being dissolves into the oblivion, that journey is human development. So during this journey, what are all that factors, specifically cultural factors, that have its impact and effect on this development, we are going to discuss today. So these factors have certain concepts which influence on the developmental aspects. We'll start with the introduction. What culture is? Culture is a set of learned behavioral patterns that has been acquired by intergenerational transfer of knowledge and manifested by a group of people. One thing is very, very clear in the definition is it's a knowledge which has been transferred from one generation to the next generation. It is a collective behavior in context of ethnicity, traditions, dressing style, art and literature, language, religion, music and food, etc. People live by their inherited traditional style and pattern to preserve it by systematic transmission to next generation. In digital parlance, it is simply known as a social or cultural programming of a child. Means the socialization is a process, and socializing agents, they culturally program the child so that child behaves and adopts the cultural norms and behaves as per these norms which are accepted by the specific culture. So it is rightly said it is social programming. Culture is dynamic in nature, which varies with time and universal in its individual scope. What does universal connotes is an individual retains his or her cultural footprints even after she or he remains away from it for longer period or from by distance. That individual never forgets the cultural footprints learned, that programming, initial programming learned in the formative years. You can look at here as a beautiful board. I've just taken it from internet. India is a melting pot of cultures. 22 languages, almost all religion of the world are found in the India. See, Hinduism, Jainism, Buddhism, Sikhism, Islam, Christianity, and all this when melt together, comes together, they form a one new concept. We call it as a Indian. So we'll discuss certain factors first. These 8 factors we are going to discuss in this video. First is ethnicity and child rearing, customs and traditions, festivals and clothing, art and literature, food and its preparation, language and dialects, religion and practices, and music and melody. We'll start with ethnicity and child rearing. Ethnicity is a broad term that encompasses cultural factors such as religion, nationality, ancestry, dialect, cultural heritage, etc. In order to be a member of an ethnic group, an individual is required to follow group-specific cultural traditions. The child rearing is dependent upon the ethnic code of cultural conduct, where it derives its methodology from ethnicity. In response to it, the child learns to respond along the lines of demands of cultural system in vogue. Here, I want to make it clear with a small video where a father in Indian context how feeds a small baby. You can see it here. It had a 7-second video. See, the baby is being consuming some food or something. See, the father how feeds. It's a very interesting phenomena where children are culturally fed, reared, and according to the ethnicity of the specific culture. So, second is customs and traditions. The customs are the practices of cultural patterns, and traditions are the transfer of customs from one generation to the next. Simple one thing. Customs are what are the practices we do in our daily life, in our culture specific. That is our customs. And when these customs are transferred from one generation to the next generation, that becomes tradition. It includes how people act, wear, eat or behave in social gatherings and specific situations. For example, during marriage and other family functions. These images clearly depicts the cultural and traditions aspects of Indian context. See, these are the two, they are playing with small sticks. So, these are customs and traditions. For example, in India, you will find women with their decorate their head, forehead with some bindi and gents with some sandalwood paste. And when we greet someone, that is we Indians, when we greet someone, we greet with folded hands. It is a part of customs and traditions. And children development is purely influenced by these customs and traditions. Now CNT, we call it culture and customs and tradition, influences cognition and physical development of a child in a significant way. It is safe to say that the child's behavior is the product of interaction of various CNT activities. These are relatively difficult to change. Yes, customs are and traditions are very difficult. I won't say that it is very impossible to change, but they are difficult to change because individuals find psychological comfort and in some sort of satisfaction in adhering to them. Because they offer a comfort, purely a psychological comfort, and that's why it has become, they are permanent and relatively difficult to change. Third is festivals and clothing. In short form, we'll call it F&C. The festivals and clothing style are the physical manifestation of culture. If you want to study culture, you want just by visual, you just visit the various festivals and observe the clothing style. Individual can very well understand the culture of that specific society. Affiliation binds a cultural group into one cohesive unit. The child learns the skills of cooperation, sharing, adjustment, and collective celebration through festivals. They are very important social institutions, festivals are. The attachment, affiliation motives, which are most important motive for human being, are satisfied through F&C that helps in cementing the cultural bonds. They are important source of releasing the pent-up stress and energy. Yes, festivals. During festivals, the pent-up energy, which is the major cause of stress and tension in individual, is getting released through these festivals. Collectively, F&C aspect of culture is an important feeder of ingredients. That are faith, love, belongingness, brotherhood, contentment, harmony with nature, good hope, etc. and etc. These are the feeders that ingredients are fed by the culture that fosters the human development. Next is art and literature, A and L. Art and literature is considered as the mirror of a culture. The creative beauty and entertaining feature of behavior is addressed through art and literature. It presents the contemporary image of society for all to see and reflect upon. Child is trained by the social agents in traditions of art and literature in order to preserve and propagate their culture. That is the basic funda. Why they train a child in particular art and literature? Because they know they have to preserve it and to propagate it to the next generation. That's why they train that child in art and literature. They inspire the generations. Art and literature inspire the generations. Last thousands of years before art has been created, and those who are modern generation reading nowadays and visualizing that art, that inspires that how our forefathers or ancestors were so creative and inculcate appreciation for the culture, that our culture was so rich. This art and literature are the testimony of the richness of a culture, a kind of internal monologue initiated by art and literature. If you visit some art or we read some literature of particular culture, we start talking ourselves inside due to that reading or visualization, because that's kind of internal monologue. The interaction of ideas germinates art that helps in progressive evolution of mankind. This means the evolution of mankind is somewhere a function of art and literature, because the idea germinates through art and literature. Next is food and its preparation. Food, especially in Indian context, is a millions of variety, and it carries some cultural specific cues. Food, its preparation and consumption pattern represents the strong cultural, geographical and social identity. It is the repository of traditions and customs. Rightly said, that food has a type of warehouse which is consisted of various traditions and cultures and its components. You call it as a food is a real sense repository. Food influences the child psychological and physical aspects. This is very interesting. Take example of Haryana, where the food is basically very rich. Milk products are the basic ingredients and diet of the Haryanvi people. That's why they nurture high caliber sports persons, especially in contact sports like wrestling, boxing, kabaddi, etc. etc. Another example is, in Hinduism, consumption of non-veg food is considered as a sin, because Hinduism believes in ahimsa, non-violence. So killing an animal for the food is a violence, which is just against the Hinduism. So food and style of preparation is also an important factor that influences the child development. Lévi-Strauss has said that cooking food using fire is the only invention, I will say, which made human beings human. That is the difference between us and other living beings. We cook our food using fire, and that is the basic difference. He rightly said, it permanently embeds culture-specific taste that influences the growth and development of a child. I want to mention it very here. One point is, suppose an Indian is staying away in some Kamchatka peninsula, or it is Siberia, or deep forest in Brazil or Amazon, any country you take an example, and that individual Indian smells preparation of jalebis or barfis or halwa, that smell itself initiate the process of recalling of food-specific memory, food-specific cultural components of that individual. Through this, individual remembers and recalls various cultural aspects. That's why it has been rightly said that food is the repository of culture. Language and dialects. These are symbols. What is the language? Language are, and dialects are the symbols that manifest ideas and thoughts in a cultural perspective. Language, a basic instinct. It was called by Chomsky in 1960, is developed through socio-cultural interaction. He gave the concept of universal grammar, a learning acquisition device. Learning and dialects, that is language and dialects, provides a platform to the child for reception and stimulating inputs and expression of self. The social and cultural setup provides opportunities for learning that influences the direction and magnitude of development. According to Vygotsky, a Russian psychologist, the words serve as a mental tool to be used in service of self-regulation. Words are the tools, mental tools used for self-regulation. By virtue of language, individual tends to read culture-specific literature which buttresses the cultural bond further. Language and dialects shape our cognition that makes us truly a human being. Religion and practices. Religion is an organized set of regulations shaped by history, geographical location, and culture. It affects psychophysical health, social values, economics, and spirituality of followers. Child learns and acquires religiosity from the society and cultural involvement that complement her in most aspects. Which are that aspects? Safety, health, self, hope, etc. The religion is guiding light that teaches moral values and path to social reconciliation. Swami Vivekananda said, religion is the idea which raises the brute into man and man unto universal power. The religion in its conservative form can have negative effect on the developmental aspects of human being. This is the only negative part of religion. If religion becomes to be into the followers of religion, start behaving in conservative aspect of it, then it can have very devastating effect, which is being visible in modern world in the form of terrorism. So dear friends, this is the last music and melody. Music is the expression of melody of creation by human beings. See, read it once again, that nature has created a melody in its aspects. And man, through its creative aspect, has expressed it in most beautiful form. Interestingly, human beings across the globe respond to music in universal way and similar way. Music is the non-invasive techniques that steers and resonates in the neural mechanism. Non-invasive means that without any operation, without any cut, without any invasion of the brain. This means music travels in the brain and neural mechanism without any cut or any operation. So powerful music is. It improves intelligence, concentration, happiness, and keeps the brain healthy. That's why it is called that musicians have healthiest brain. Music is known to calm the mind, that improves the productivity. Children who are exposed to music in their early life tends to be smarter in their future life. Music helps students excel in the following ways. As Brown and L. said, improved language development, small increase in IQ intelligence quotient, improved test scores, increased brain connectivity, and increased spatial intelligence. D. Dear friends, these were the cultural factors of human development. These are the references you can cross-check. And our next lecture will be on prenatal development. By the time, friends, if you have any suggestion, any doubt, or anything you want to say, you can contact me through my email vermasujit@yahoo.com. Thank you, friends. We'll meet you in the next presentation with our next topic, that is prenatal development. Once again, thank you for watching the video.